Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, we are going to be diving into another mystery that, once again, on the surface level seems to be a simple Easter egg, but there's actually a bigger, deeper, and darker mystery going on here, and that is the mystery of the warped tree. So if you've never seen the warped tree before, it's located in the Heartlands, New Hanover. And once again, on the surface level, things seem to be pretty simple here. You see the tree and it certainly looks as if something has gone on here. Now, my best guess and estimation is that this tree was struck by lightning. And that's why you see some of the branches hanging off, and that's why you see that it's dead, because once the tree was struck by lightning, you knew that it was no longer going to survive. And you can actually inspect the tree. It's a point of interest. It's called Warped Tree, and Arthur just simply draws it. He doesn't write anything down about it. So again, on the surface level, you might think to yourself, okay, this is a relatively simple Easter egg. However, what I want to focus on here is the grave underneath the tree. It has a simple rock border with some dirt and a cross. And there doesn't seem to be any names or any other objects near this grave. Now, the reason I'm checking this out today is I got a Facebook message from one of you guys, Alex, who said that I should investigate this. And this brings up another point that I've been wanting to talk about for a bit. If you guys have anything you'd like me to check out or investigate or think is interesting in Red Dead Redemption 2 or Red Dead Online, feel free to send me a message on Facebook. I don't plug my social media a lot. I feel like Facebook is the easiest because I don't have to be following you for you to message me. You can send me photos and videos and long messages. There's no character limit. So the link to my Facebook is in the description, like it has been in every video. You just might not have known about it. It's a great way to get in touch with me. And if you find something interesting or cool, I might check it out and feature it in a video. So Alex mentioned this to me, and I think it's worth checking out and exploring because I want to know who is buried underneath this grave at the warped tree. It's kind of been bothering me, and I want to figure out what's going on here. Now, the only other clue I could figure out here is right next to the warped tree is a small little ranch called Larned Sod. Now, hopefully I'm pronouncing that correctly. I think it's Larned Sod or Larned, one of those two. And I think that someone that used to live there is under the grave. But once again, there's more than meets the eye here, because if we actually visit this farm, we're going to be met with a less than pleasant rancher. So the first time I actually arrived here, I didn't do anything. I just simply showed up at his house. He comes storming out the front door with his gun in hand and tells us to get out of here. And we had to go sprinting off unless he was going to start shooting at us. So he didn't even give us the chance to introduce ourselves. He was just immediately hostile. Now, after that happened, one of the weirdest things ever occurred. I went up on this hill, and apparently this guy had to use the restroom. Okay, there's no problem with that. However, the problem is this guy used the restroom for like 8 minutes straight. Now, I don't know about you guys, but there has never been a point in my life where I had to use the restroom, at least in this capacity, for 8 minutes straight. And you guys can see he's literally just taking a whiz on the tree, and he does so nonstop. Stop, start, stop, start, but he keeps going forever. So that was kind of weird. Again, I'm not sure if that's related in any way, shape, or form to this mystery, but I did find it incredibly odd. Maybe this guy had just finished drinking a ton of water. Who knows? Now, I was getting a little bit tired of waiting for this guy to finish using the restroom, so I ended up trying to go down and talk to him again. And once again, he was incredibly hostile. Didn't even give us the chance to run away. He just started shooting at us. Now, this is where something kind of interesting happens. I was trying to outrun him, and I eventually successfully did so, where his dot was no longer red on the minimap. And when I returned to the grave or the house, he was nowhere to be found. So I checked up where the grave and the warped tree was located, and you guys can see that he was just visiting the grave. He had just come from checking that out, and now he was walking back down the hill. So what I think this means is that whoever lives at this ranch is some way, shape, or form connected to the person buried inside of that grave on the hill underneath the warped tree. So after that, I felt like I needed to get face to face with this farmer, with this rancher, and find out some more details to figure out who this possibly could be. So the best thing I wanted to do here was lasso him and see if he had anything on him, a letter, or if he would say some line of dialogue. And unfortunately, we got neither of those from this guy. He didn't say anything specific to the actual grave, and there wasn't anything specific on him when I tried to loot him as well. He just had a couple of cents, and that's it. So that was a little bit disappointing right there. He did have a ring on him, which we'll talk about that in a little bit. But from there, I wanted to go check out the inside of the cabin to see if we could find anything. Now, on the surface level, there didn't seem to be anything in the cabin that was all too revealing. I was looking for photos or a document or anything along those lines. I started checking all the cabinets to see what was going on. However, I think there's two things we can notice here. Number one is the bed. It's like a queen size or double bed made for two people. So since this guy is the only one on the property, maybe we can assume that whoever is in that grave used to sleep with him in the same bed. You would assume that someone like that would either be a wife, girlfriend, fiance, someone like that. Now this can further be backed up by the jewelry that we can actually grab on the desk. It's a silver emblem ring. Now, what's interesting about that is that same silver emblem ring was the one we looted off of him. So jewelry that can be found on this little dresser right here was also found on the farmer, the rancher. So maybe this was his once wife or fiance, and that was her wedding ring or ring that they had, matching jewelry. I'm really not too sure. But that theory to me seems to make sense. Now, the rest of the house doesn't really give away a lot. There's like a sewing machine, there's a fire, there's a stove, there's, you know, just a table in the center. And another thing, the table in the center has two chairs. And then there's a stool on the other side, but the two chairs, again, to me indicates that this is likely someone that used to live at this ranch. Now, I am going to guess and speculate based off of all the information we have so far that whoever is buried underneath that grave on top of the hill under the warp tree is the wife, fiance, or girlfriend or significant other of this rancher. And this is backed up for several reasons. Number one, he goes to check on the grave on a daily basis, which means that whoever is inside held some sort of significant value to him. Number two, we can also see the inside of the house has features like another individual lived there, like matching jewelry and a bigger bed meant for more than one person. And the fact that this guy is so hostile instantly means that this event likely happened sooner rather than later. He's probably not in a great mood and is still recovering from grieving or mourning the loss of whoever was up there. So now that we know all of that information, I wanted to try some experiments to see what would happen. The first experiment I wanted to try is what would happen if we brought this guy up to the grave, very similar to Tammy Aberdeen and the Aberdeen Pig Farm, where if you brought her to that corpse pit, she would have some unique lines of dialogue. Well, unfortunately, we don't get anything here. In fact, this guy really doesn't want to follow you up there all that much, but when he does, he's obviously very hostile. So that didn't work. So the next thing I wanted to do was, okay, maybe I have to hog tie him, similar to what I did in the Aberdeen Pig Farm video. If you hog tie him and put him on the grave, will he actually say anything? Once again, the answer here is no. So unfortunately, that is not the case. So I left him there, I slept, I waited till the next day, I returned, and he was just as angry. He was actually working in his goat pen over there. And once again, he was immediately hostile and wanted you to leave his ranch almost instantly. So although we're sort of leaving this video without an exact answer of who is inside of that grave and who is buried there, I think we generally have a good idea. It's the significant other of this very hostile rancher here at this farm called Larned Sod. Again, I don't know if there's a bigger backstory here or if we will ever get more information on who's buried at this grave. I even tried to do some digging around at various campfires. In fact, I even started to go around this area to see if I could find any strangers on the side of the road that might offer some conversations, but unfortunately that didn't lead to anything either. So for now, I'm going to say that this mystery is somewhat solved. Let's call it loosely solved. I think we have a general idea of who is inside of this grave under the warp tree, but I don't think we know anything official as far as specifics. And we might never know until we find some more information, at least that I couldn't stumble upon or didn't stumble upon in this video today. But anyways, that's all the information that I've got for you guys in this video today. Hopefully you did enjoy. As always, let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below on what you think of this mystery and who you think is buried in that grave. Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more down there. If you guys did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you like daily Red Dead Redemption 2 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.